Fungal infections of the private parts are one of the most frequent complaints for which women go to see doctors around the world. That is all about to change. Stick around to learn more. It is estimated that 138 million women suffer from vaginal fungal infections every year worldwide. Vaginal fungal infections occur most frequently in women during their reproductive years, and this is directly related to the levels of estrogen found in the vagina. Women who are prepubertal or postmenopausal have lower levels of estrogen in their body and thus in the vagina. And for that reason, they suffer vaginal fungal infections less frequently. It is for that same reason that women who take high estrogen birth control pills suffer vaginal fungal infections, yeast infections, more frequently. About 90% of vaginal fungal infections, yeast infections, are caused by Candida albicans. The remaining 10% are caused by other species of Candida, such as Candida glabrata, which causes about 8% of the remaining 10%, and Candida tropicalis and Candida parasilosis. These are most frequently found in postmenopausal women, tend to be less severe symptom-wise, and quite often are drug-resistant. Candida are a normal part of the vaginal flora in many women and do not cause disease. The fungus exists in two forms, a spherical yeast form and a filamentous hyphal form. Under certain circumstances, the spherical yeast form transforms into the filamentous hyphal form, which is able to adhere to the walls of the vagina, penetrate the cells, and cause an intense inflammatory reaction, leading to what is called vulvovaginitis. Risk factors for candidal vulvovaginitis include immune suppression and uncontrolled diabetes mellitus, or taking drugs like antibiotics, broad-spectrum antibiotics, or certain medications that are used to treat diabetes known as SGLT2 inhibitors. Candida vulvovaginitis presents with itching and burning and redness and swelling and pain during sexual intercourse, and there's usually a white discharge. If a person suffers from more than 4 episodes a year, they're said to have recurrent vulvovaginal candidiasis. Vaginal fungal infections are normally treated with topical and oral medications, but in the case of chronic recurrent infections, treatment may be required for up to 6 months. The discomfort and inconvenience caused by sporadic as well as recurrent chronic vaginal infections, and the fact that candidal infections in the blood occur relatively frequently in hospital settings, means that the development of a vaccine is desirable. 2 such vaccines are currently undergoing development, PEV7 and NDV3A. NDV3A has already been proven to be safe and effective at preventing recurrent vulvovaginal candidiasis in women below the ages of 40 after a single shot and up to 1 year. The vaccine contains a protein known as the ALS3 protein or a glutenin-like sequence 3 protein that is found on the surface of the hyphal form or the filamentous form of the fungus. And it is this protein that allows the fungus to adhere to the surface of the vagina, penetrate the vaginal cells, and cause infection. Once this ALS3 protein is blocked by antibodies triggered by the vaccine, the fungus is no longer able to cause infection, and anyone who is vaccinated is protected. It is expected that this vaccine should be on the market in the near future. And after vaccination, women who have recurrent vulvovaginal candidiasis may never again have another infection. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, like, leave your comments in the box below, share the video with your friends and family, and support the channel by subscribing. Until the next video, stay healthy and stay safe.